that flower. Every day is a busy day for the engines of the Narrow Gauge Controllers Railway. They toot hello as they pass each other on the hills. Puff and puff at the transfer yards.
The yards.
And push and pull freight cars at the wharf.
The wharf at Maine?
Early one morning, Thomas was at the wharf. He liked the wharf. It was busy and he met a lot of his friends there. But today, Thomas was shunting trucks. And the trucks were being especially troublesome. It was taking all of Thomas's puff to keep them in order. Then James arrived.
Hi, Amy.
I am to collect a car of flour to make cakes and bread for the children's harvest festival supper.
The supper?
I wish Sir Topham Hatt had given me that job, Chuff Thomas. It would be so much more fun than shunting troublesome trucks. James was feeling very pleased with himself. First, I have to take on water, he whistled grandly. Please shunt the flour car over for me, Thomas. Thomas didn't want to shunt any more cars. It meant his job would go on for even longer to shunt any more cars. It meant his job would go on for even longer.
Bossy boiler, he puffed.
Thomas found the flour car outside the warehouse. He wanted to move James's car as quickly as he could, so Thomas wasn't taking care. He biffed the car very hard.
Ooh, flour?
But Thomas didn't see. An idea had flown into his funnel. I'll hide James's car. Then Bossy Boiler will have to find me. Thomas thought hide and seek was a grand idea.
Oh, boy.
James came back from the water tower. He saw Thomas in the distance. And James saw that falling from the car was a trail of flour.
Uh-oh.
Stop, Thomas, whistled James. Flour is falling out of your car. But Thomas was too far away to hear. Thomas puffed into the warehouse to find somewhere to hide. More and more flour through the warehouse to find somewhere to hide. More and more flour fell from the car.
Not again.
James chased after Thomas. Thomas heard him coming. How does he know where I am? Thought Thomas.
Me neither.
Thomas! The flower! Whistled James. But Thomas couldn't hear him. James won't find me this time, he thought. Thomas was having fun. Thomas found another good place to hide. James will never find me here, he hooted happily. Then, he heard James's whistle again. Bust my buffers, Chuff Thomas. He heard James's whistle again. Bust my buffers, Chuff Thomas. He's found me again. So Thomas puffed off. Thomas had reversed behind some freight cars. James will never find me here, he tooted cheerily. But just then, he saw James come around the bend.
Uh-oh.
Thomas, puffed James. He was very cross. You've left a trail of flour all over the wharf. Cinders and ashes, cried Thomas, all over the wharf. Cinders and ashes, cried Thomas. I must have biffed the car so hard that the door came loose. Thomas didn't feel cheery anymore. If I've lost all the flour, there'll be no cakes and bread for the children's harvest festival supper, he wished sadly. I'm sorry, James, he chuffed. I'll get you another car of flour. Then you won't be late for the children. Thomas raced away. Thomas puffed. And he huffed, he wished, and he whooshed. He had to get to the mill as fast as he could. trouble. When Thomas arrived at the mill, it was closed. Thomas looked around. He could only see empty flour cars. Thomas felt sadder than ever. Dusty Dave, the miller, came to see Thomas. He could see that Thomas was very upset.
I'm going home for my supper now, he told Thomas, but there's one full flour car right at the back.
Thomas saw the flour car, but there were lots of other cars in the way. He needed help. Thomas whooshed back to the wharf. He would have to ask James to help him. He would have to ask James to help him. James was waiting. He was still very cross. Thomas pulled up alongside him. James, I know you tried to tell me about the flower, and I know I was silly, but now I need your help. James knew that Thomas was sorry, and he knew Thomas needed his help. So they set off for the mill. James and Thomas worked hard. There were lots of freight cars to shovel, but they worked well together.
Teamwork.
The flour car was coupled up to James, and he raced off. Thomas felt proud of his friend. Later that evening, Sir Topham Hatt stood by a table of wonderful breads and cakes. The children were very excited. Thomas puffed by on his way home. Well done, James, he tooted. And James tooted back. Thomas was pleased James was his friend again. And Thomas smiled all the way back to Tidmouth Sheds.